So Steam Link, my beautiful, beautiful Steam Link that lets you stream games from your gaming machine down to any display with the HDMI port is being discontinued.
Oh, no.
Well, the good news is that Valve, even though they're not going to make the hardware anymore, they're going to keep working on that software and make it available for free. And one of the easiest ways to get that going is with a Raspberry Pi. So today, I'm going to show you how to turn a Raspberry Pi into a Steam Link. So here we go.
Game on!
Game on!
So because I know I'll get questions about it, I'm using a Raspberry Pi bundle in this video. It's called the Canna Kit. It gives you the Raspberry Pi, the case, the power, everything you need to get going. I'll put a link down in the description that'll take you to that. And as I'm going through this tutorial, if you think of any questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section below. And with all that out of the way, let's get right to it. So the first thing you're gonna need is a micro SD card that goes in the Raspberry Pi. Once you get that, load it into your card reader, stick it into your computer, and then we'll jump in and do the rest of this. All right, so here we are in the desktop, and I'm gonna be doing this in Linux, but the process is exactly the same in Linux, Mac, or Windows, so it doesn't matter what operating system you're on, you're gonna use all the same software and everything. So after we insert the SD card into the computer, we're gonna need a few pieces of software. The first one is Raspbian Stretch. Now this is the operating system that we're gonna be loading onto that SD card to boot up the Raspberry Pi. And if you're familiar with this, grab whatever version you want. If you're not familiar with it, just grab this one with the recommended software. It has everything you need on there. It's a little bit more bloated than what you need, but it'll just get you up and going and be kind of painless. So either download the zip directly or download through torrent. The torrent, you're gonna get it a little bit faster, but it's exactly the same. And then when you download it, you'll get this Raspbian Stretch full zip. Go ahead and extract that. And when you extract it, you'll get the .img file. So that part's done. Next part, we need to get Etcher. If you don't have it already, go out to the site. I'll put this site and the site, actually everything I talk about, I'll put in the description. But go out to here, download Etcher. This is just a free image writing program. So once you have those two things, go ahead and start up Etcher. And we're gonna go and select that IMG file. So it's right here, but I'm just gonna navigate to my downloads folder. An image, that's where it's going to be on your system most likely, or wherever you extracted that IMG. Open that up, select your drive, and continue. Now just flash it. If it prompts you for a password, go ahead and enter it. And this is going to take a few minutes, but it'll write everything you need onto that SD card to boot up your Raspberry Pi. So while this is going, I want to talk about this other tab that I have open here. And this is to actually install Steam Link after we get the Raspberry Pi up and going. So we're not gonna do that on this machine, but we're gonna run these commands after we get the Raspberry Pi all set up, and this'll load Steam Link onto our Raspberry Pi. All right, so now Etcher's done and that image is written to the SD card. All we need to do now is take that out of the computer, put it into the Raspberry Pi and fire it up. All right, so here we are in the Raspberry Pi. This is the Raspbian OS. Now, when you first start up your Raspberry Pi, it's gonna take a really, really, really long time. So just be patient. It'll eventually come up to this screen. And then we're just gonna go through these settings real quick. Now, at this point, if you're using an Ethernet cable, which if you're doing this game streaming, you probably should, you're gonna get better performance. You won't have to do this, but obviously I'm not using that right now, so I need to select my wireless network. You can still do this off the wireless network. It's just gonna work better off of wired. So if you get this message asking you to update the software, go ahead and do that now. This will just download updates from the internet and apply them to your system. This will take just another few minutes as well. All right, so we are all updated, rebooted, and ready to go. So this is the fun part. Now we use those commands that we looked at earlier. So we're going to type sudo apt update. So next thing we're going to do is sudo apt install Steam Link. So that is all downloaded and everything. So now we just launch Steam Link. And it's automatically going out and getting all those updates. So here we are, now we're in Steam Link. We can go through the Get Started menu here. I am using just a generic wired Xbox 360 controller, and I'm gonna select pair another controller. The one on the left is my laptop and the one on the right is my gaming machine. So I'm gonna select that. And then on the machine, you have to enter in this code. There'll be a little pop-up that comes up. You enter in that code and everything syncs up for you. Okay, so there we go. We made the connection and it did a network test. And since I'm on the wireless, it found some issues. So there's kind of high latency. There's no frame loss, but might have some problems with the wireless. So we're all connected. We can go ahead and click on start playing. It'll connect to my gaming machine. All right, so here we are in Steam Link. I'm just using the 360 controller to navigate through the menus here. And we'll go into library and let's launch up a game real quick and try it out. Again, these are all playing on my gaming machine and streaming to the Raspberry Pi through the Steam Link software. So here we go, even over a 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi, you can see that it still works really, really well. It's smooth, I'm not getting any lag right now. The controls are very, very responsive. If you're seeing any lag, it's probably because I'm recording this at 24 frames per second. So keep that in mind. But on my screen, it is completely lag-free and extremely playable. And then if you want even better performance, you can hook up the wired connection and you know, you'll get a little less latency than you will over the Wi-Fi. Now, if you ever want to get out of Steam Link and get back to the Raspbian OS, it's super easy to do so. You just come back up here, hit the little power thing, and stop streaming. And this will dump you right back to the desktop. And that's it. Anytime you want to launch into Steam Link, you just start up your Raspberry Pi, type in Steam Link, and you're off and running. Now, there are ways to auto-start Steam Link when you start up your Raspberry Pi. Those are a little more complicated and a little beyond the scope of this video, but if you want to see that, I'm happy to make a video on it. Just let me know down in the comment section. All right, so that's all there is to it. As you can see, it is super easy to turn your Raspberry Pi into a Steam Link. Again, if you have any questions or comments, leave those in the comments section below. If you found this useful and informative, please hit the thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing so and then hitting that notification bell. It'll let you know when I put up a new one of these videos. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I will see you in the next one.